The question asked by Johnny is, how is a person manipulated? How does the society manipulate a person? It's simple, Johnny, it's obvious, isn't it? The best way to enslave somebody is to tell him, condition him very, very deeply that the prison is a palace, a beautiful palace of freedom. Then he won't even run away. You can be liberated from a prison, you can escape from a prison only if you first identify a prison as a prison, right? If you start believing that handcuffs are beautiful ornaments and the walls of the prison are the walls of a temple worth worshipping, then you will never escape. It's so easy to manipulate someone. Just create a belief system within his mind and he can be manipulated, very easily manipulated. It's not at all difficult. So many people complain that they are not free. But do they really realize what holds them back? You have given beautiful names to your bondages. And when you give beautiful names to something that is ugly, then it is easy to be deceived. There was a wonderful thinker in the last century. He was fond of narrating a particular story. He used to say that there was a magician once who had lots of sheep, right? And obviously he used to have the sheep for slaughter to eat their meat. But to manage so many sheep was a little difficult. The sheep would run away and such things. So what did the magician do? The magician took all the sheep and brainwashed them, hypnotized them, made them believe that they are human beings. And he told the sheep that you are not sheep at all. You are free and liberated human beings. Sheep are slaughtered, you won't be slaughtered. You are free, intelligent, liberated human beings. And the sheep said, very good. We are human beings, we won't be slaughtered. And now the sheep won't run away. Now the sheep won't go anywhere. Even when they would see that some other sheep is being slaughtered, they would say, oh, she is a sheep, she is being slaughtered. I will not be slaughtered, I am a human being. You ask about the society's power to manipulate you. This is how it happens. You tell a slave that you are a slave and he'll have a desire to escape. But if you brainwash a slave into accepting that he's free, he will never want to be free. He'll say, I'm already free, who wants to be free? We have given great names to our bondages. Names like relationships, names like religion, names like goals and targets and career. And we think that these are very, very valuable things. We have become deeply attached to them. We have been repeatedly told by the society, family, media that these are valuable things. This is what makes life worth living. And it is through this conditioning, through this brainwashing, that the external is able to manipulate you. Nobody can manipulate you really. By telling you overtly that you are being manipulated, because then you will resist. All of you are young. And if someone comes to you and says straight away that I am going to make a slave of you, you will say I will fight till my death, but I will not become a slave, right? So nobody. The society is quite shrewd, quite deceptive. It knows that it is dangerous to tell a young man on his face that he is being enslaved. So it does not tell you directly, honestly. Instead, it says, you are free, you are very free, and religion is another name of your freedom. So please borrow this religion, and when you belong to such and such religion, then this is the way you must act, and you think that this is part of your freedom. So quite deceptively, you are being enslaved in the name of other things. In the name of other things. In the name of what appears beautiful, what appears like freedom, but is not really freedom, one is enslaved.